In one of my previous video, I talked about session-based authentication using Passport.js and Mongoose. I touched on the main thing about the Passport middleware and how it uses authentication strategies. In this video, I will focus on JWT authentication. We'll look what a JSON Web Token is in a nutshell. Consider the concept of JWT authentication and its practical implementation using JWT strategy for the Passport.js. Please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. JSON Web Token is a JSON object consists of three parts. Header, storing the signature algorithm and token type, usually JWT. The payload is all we need to authenticate the user. Typically user data such as ID and name. Also additional information such as issued ad and expiration ad. The signature is a hash of the header and payload signed with a secret string. This ensures that the client has not modified the token payload. This is how JWT authentication works. The client app sends a sign-in request. In my case, it is the login and password. If successful, the server creates a token and signs it with the secret key. The API returns the token to the client. The resulting token will be attached to subsequent requests and allow the server to authenticate them based on the token payload. Let's try to take a closer look at why servers trust token data. The signature is a hash of the header and payload created using the secret. The secret is kept securely, and no one except the issuer knows it. The client may try to change some attributes, such as the user ID, in order to log in as someone else. But he doesn't know the secret and can't create a valid signature for the modified payload. For each token coming from the client to the server, a new test signature is created and compared with the original one attached to the token. Therefore, any substitution in the token will be noticed and the request will be rejected. My main stack is the Express.js Node framework and the Mongoose library on top of MongoDB. Let's see what else we need to implement authentication with JWT. I'm using cookies to pass a token between client and server. So I need a cookie parser that will attach a cookie object to the request. In this line, I have set the local strategy for the Passport middleware. The local strategy encapsulates the login request processing logic. This method is part of the Passport Mongoose local plugin, which is attached to the user model class where the user schema is created. This plugin provided some additional functionality related to the passport, including the create strategy method that we used. This is the login controller that receives the user's login requests. The passport middleware uses a local strategy that implicitly does some work to validate the passage credentials and returns the user object from the database. Here we are simply checking that there are no errors and everything is okay with the user returned by the local authentication process. And if yes, then we create a token. To do this, I use the sign function from the JSON Web Token package. The first parameter is user data, and the second is a secret string that I store in environment variables. In the options, I set the expiration time. The function creates a JSON object for us consisting of the payload, header, and signature and converts them to base64. I'm using cookies to send a token to the client. Set HTTP only to true to prevent JavaScript from accessing the token. And set secure to true for production, which ensures cookies are only sent over a secure HTTPS connection. The expiration time will be the same as what I used for the token. This is what the token looks like on the client side in the browser. This long string, separated into three parts by dots, is itself a base64 encoded token. Let's try to convert it back to JSON format using an online decoder website. I delete the last part after the dot because it's a signature and click decoder, and we got the original JSON. So once a client has a token in its cookies, we need to set up a strategy to obtain and verify it, to authenticate every incoming request. I'm using the JWT strategy from the Passport JWT package. By default, it doesn't support retrieving the token from cookies. So I need to set up my own extractor and pass it as an option. The strategy decrypts the token and returns a payload with user data. Based on the user ID, we can find and retrieve the user from the database to pass it on. After defining the JWT strategy, we need to apply it to routers that require authentication. I do this with the middleware function isAuthenticated. Here we say to the passport to use the JWT strategy to process requests. Send back an HTTP 401 unauthorized status if an error occurred or the user was not found. If successful, we attach the user object to the request and call next. It is important that authenticated requests contain a user object that can be accessed in subsequent stages of the request processing. Take a look at the logout process. Just remove JWT from cookies and the user will be logged out. In this video, we covered the theory and practice of JSON Web Token authentication with Passport.js. Check the code in my GitHub. Write in comments if you want me to talk about other authentication methods. Like and subscriptions are also welcome. Thank you.